Hello everyone. Today we will explain the first grammar lesson in your course. Its name is Necessity and Obligation. The obligation. To express the obligation, we use must plus the infinitive. And the passive form of must is must plus verb to be plus the PP. The most important thing that you know is the usage of must. We use must to express strong obligation to do something. Such as I say, athletes must get a special heart examination. Or when you want to give strong advice, especially to your relatives or someone who is close to you. Like you say, you must stop smoking. You must stop eating unhealthy food. Also, when the speaker has decided that something is necessary for him, the obligation must come from inside the speaker himself. Such as, I must remember to send my mother a birthday card. He thinks that's important for him, but it's not a rule. We use must also to express a warm invitation, such as, you must try this piece of cake. You must come to my birthday party. In the question, the question form of must is must add a helping verb and then we put the subject and we put the verb in the infinitive. Notice that we can use must as a noun. When I say it's a must to eat healthy food, here must means a necessity. To express the necessity, we use have to or has to plus the infinitive. In the passive form, it will be have to or has to plus P plus the past participle verb. We use have to or has to say that something is very necessary or important to be done. Or when we talk about rules, when somebody other than the speaker has decided that something is necessary. Like I say, children have to pee at school before 7:30. It's a school rule. He said we have to follow the instructions. Someone else ordered him to do that. When the speaker has no other choices, we use have to or has to. He has to pass this driving exam or he can't have a driving license. In the question, we begin with do or does plus the subject plus have to plus the infinitive. Then we must note that to express laws, we can use must or have to. If the subject was indefinite or we talk in general about general subjects like drivers, passengers, citizens, we use must. It's a formal law. Drivers must have a driving license to drive their cars. Here the subject is drivers. But when I say you have to wear your safety belt, here the subject is you, and it's definite. We don't talk in general. We can use need to or needs to plus the infinitive, or have or has got to plus the infinitive to express the necessity in the present too. Then we will move to the necessity in the past. To express the necessity in the past, we use had to plus the infinitive or needed to plus the infinitive. Like, I had to attend the meeting last Monday. Here, we have last Monday, and that refers to the past, so we use had to. In the future, we use will have to plus the infinitive or will need to plus the infinitive. Like I say, I will have to take the train at 7:30 tomorrow. Now we have the prohibition. The prohibition means mana or tahrim. We use mustn't plus the infinitive to express the prohibition, and the passive form is mustn't plus be plus the PP. We use mustn't when we want to say that something is forbidden to be done, or it's banned to, or it's prohibited, it's illegal, it's dangerous, it's harmful, it's against law or against the rules. When you have no plus ing, such as there is a sign says no swimming, so you mustn't swim here. You aren't allowed or you aren't permitted to do something. Okay? Next, we have the lack of necessity. When you want to say that it's not necessary or it's not important to do something in the present, we use don't or doesn't have to, or don't or doesn't need to plus the infinitive, or needn't but without to. After needn't, we put the verb in the infinitive. Like I say, you don't have to do the shopping, I'll do it. Or you needn't wear this heavy jacket today, the weather is fine. In the past, we use didn't have to or didn't need to plus the infinitive or needn't have plus the PP when you want to say it wasn't necessary to do something. There's a little difference between didn't have to or and needn't have PP. We use didn't have to or didn't need to when something wasn't necessary and we didn't do it. Like I say, I didn't have to go to work yesterday as it was a holiday. It wasn't necessary to go to the work, so I didn't go. But you needn't have brought your coat with you, and the weather isn't cold today here. It wasn't necessary to bring my coat, but I brought it. Finally, when you want to express the lack of necessity in the future, we will use won't have to or won't need to express it won't be necessary to do something. Thanks for listening to me and good luck.